Welcome to Eric Blackmon Music. Welcome to Eric Blackmon Guitar, where I am going to show you how I play my favorite rock instrumental of all time, Frankenstein, by the Edgar Winter Group. Now, there's a lot to unpack here, because there are enough cool riffs in this tune for three or four songs, but I believe that anyone who is willing to work at it can learn to play it. The guitar is tuned standard, E-A-D-G-B-E, and the key is G minor. We'll start with the opening riff of the song that goes like this. In order to play that riff, we're going to go to the low E string, fret 3, and play. That's four times. Go to fret 1, back to 3, twice, and then we'll go to a power chord on the A and D string at fret 1 and fret 3, and play this. Okay, that's fret 1 on the A string and fret 3 on the D string. So here it is again. We'll finish with three hits on the low E string at fret 3, fret 1, and then fret 3. So it's... So here's the entire thing once again. We'll play that twice. For our next riff connecting to that, we'll play this. For that one, we're going to go to the low E string and go open 1, 2, 3. The A string fret 1, back to the E string 3, the A string 3, fret 1, the low E string 3, the A string 1, 3, so that's go to fret 3 and slide up to fret 5. We'll move to fret 4 on the A string, play it, and slide down to 3. Play 1, so that was... Then we'll go to fret 3 on the low E string, back to 1 on the A string, and end on 3 on the low E string. So here's the entire thing. And once again, it sounds like this. Thank you. number 3 will play this. For that, we're going to go from fret 4 on the high E string up to fret 6. Back down to 3. The B string, fret 6. Then we'll move to fret 6 on the G string and slide down to 5. Fret 3. Then we'll go to fret 5 on the D string. Back to fret 3 on the G string. To fret 5. We'll slide up to fret 7. Then we'll go to the B string, fret 6. Back to fret 7 on the G string, sliding down to 5. To fret 3. And then land on the D string, fret 5. So again, that's... Now, there's a second guitar that comes in on this part, and that guitar will play this. For that, we're going to go to fret 6 on the low E string, play it twice. We'll go to the A string, fret 4, 5, 6 twice. We'll go back to 3, 4, 5. Then we'll go down to fret 1 on the low E string, 2, 3. So again, that's 6, 4, 5, 6. 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3. Here's what we'll play for riff number 4. For that one, we're going to start on the G string, fret 2, 3, 4, 5. We'll go to the B string, fret 4, back to the G string, fret 5, fret 6 on the B string, 4, fret 5 again on the G string, back to the B string, fret 4. So that was... We'll go to fret 6 on the B string, fret 4, slide from 6 to 8, go to 7, slide down to 6, fret 4, and this is all on the B string. The G string, fret 5, B string, fret 4, G string, fret 5. So again, that's... Now the next riff is exactly the same as the one we just played, except we're going to move up 2 frets from fret 2 to fret 4 to start it. So it goes like this. Now, while guitar number one is doing riff four, guitar two will strum a series of major chords, starting at fret 8 for an E flat, and we're just strumming the D, the G, and the B string, E flat at fret 10, F at fret 12, G at fret 15, B flat, and at fret 17, C. And it'll be played this way. So we start it at fret 8, and that's down, down, 10, down, up, down. Fret 8, down, up, 10, down. 10, down, down. 12, down, up, down. 15, down, up. 17, down. So that's... For the next strumming part, we'll go down to a B flat chord. And for that chord, we're holding down the D, the G, and the B string at fret 3. We'll go up to an F chord. And that F chord is going to be formed by barring from the D string down at fret 5, putting a finger on the B string, fret 6, and the D string, fret 7. We'll open that up to a C chord, and that's played by holding down fret 5 from the D string down. So we're gonna play this. And that's all down strums. Now for our next riff, we're going to go to fret 10 on the B string and do a series of bends, pulling off to fret 8. They're going to sound like this. Now I've got my index finger on fret 8, my middle finger on fret 9, and my ring finger on fret 10. And I'm going to use the middle finger and the ring finger to push up on the B string to get a nice half step bend. Like that. So I'm getting the sound that I would get at fret 11. See? So I'm going to push up, strike again, and then pull off to fret 8, like that. So I struck the string, strike it again, come down, and pull off, like that. So we're going to do it this way. Once again. Now we'll have a second guitar do the same sort of thing on the G string, except we'll pull off to a half step, like that. So we're going to hold down fret 7 with the index finger, fret 9 with the middle finger, and fret 10 with the ring finger, and we'll go like that, pulling off to fret 7. So we wound up on fret 9 on that one. So here we go again. After that, we'll go back to our main riff. And while that's going on, our second guitar will play this. Now that's really a keyboard riff, but if you want to play it on the guitar, it's played this way. So we're going to fret 5 on the G string, fret 3, fret 5 on the D string, fret 3, fret 5 on the A string, fret 4, fret 3, fret 1, and end on the E string, fret 3. So it'll be played this way. Next is Edgar's synthesizer solo, and the guitarist backs him up with some funky strumming that sounds like this. We're going to need three chords for that part. We'll need a G minor 7. And that's played by holding down everything from the D string down at fret 3. A C chord, played by holding down fret 5 as far as the D, G, and B string are concerned. We're going to raise that by one fret for a D flat. And those are our three chords. Here's how we'll strum those chords. Going to the G minor 7, down, up, down, just like that. We'll go to C and play up, up, so it's down, up, down, up, up. Then we'll go back to G minor 7, down, back to C, up. Then back to G minor 7 with a down. Nice and brisk. Then we'll go down on the G minor 7, up on the C, up on the D flat, up on the C, back to G minor 7, up, C, down, G minor 7, up. So again, it's down, up, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, 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 down, up, down, up, down, up, up, down, up, down, down, up, 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 down, up. Down, up, 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 down, up. Now we'll do that for a little while, and then we'll go to this part. That's a B flat major 7. And we're playing that by holding down the D string at fret 8, the G string at fret 7, the B string at fret 6, and the high E string at fret 5. And that's down, up, down, up, down. Then we'll go to our C chord, and that's an up strum. And then to our F chord again, down, down, and then up on the C. So it's... That's down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down, up. And then we'll do it again. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down, down. So here's the entire thing. And now, for our last strumming pattern variation, we'll play this. So we're moving from our G minor 7 to our C. Back and forth, and we'll play the G minor 7, down, up, down. We'll move to C, up, up, down. G minor 7, down, up, down. C, up, up, down, and one more up on the G minor 7. So it's down, up, down, up, up, down. Down, up, down, up, up, down, up, down, up, down, up, up, down, down, up, down, up, up, down, up. We'll do that twice. Now, let's do a recap of all the strumming behind the synth solo. For our next riff, we'll play this. For that one, we're going to go to the low E string, fret 3, 1, 3. Then we'll go to the A string, 1, 2, 3, 3. We'll go to the open E string. 1, 2, 3, 1, 3. And so far, we've got this. We'll go back to 1, 3. Then we'll go back to the A string again. 1, 2, 3, 3. Then we'll go to the D string. 2, 3, 4, five on the A string, three on the low E string. So that's 2, 3, 4, like that. And we'll strike fret 3 again. Then we'll go to fret 1 on the A string and climb again. Open on the low E string. Back to 1, 3, back to the A string, 1, 2, 3, 3, back to the open E string, and we're done. So again, the entire thing. Next, we'll go to the part where the guitar and the saxophone harmonize, and it'll be played something like this. So for part one of that riff, we'll play this. For that, we went to the A string, fret 5, 7, 8, the D string, fret 5, 7, 8, the G string, fret 5, back to the D string, fret 8, and then end on the D string, fret 5. So again, that's 5, 7, 8, 5, 7, 8, 5, 8, 5. For the second part, we'll play this. So we started at fret 8 on the A string, fret 5 on the D string, fret 7, fret 8. We'll go to fret 5 on the G string, fret 7, fret 5 on the B string, and end at fret 7 on the G string. So that's 8, 5, 7, 8, 5, 7, 5, 7, or for the third part. So we started on fret 5 of the D string, we'll go to 7, 8, 5 on the G string, fret 7, fret 5 on the B string, fret 8, fret 6, and fret 7 on the G string. So that's. will end with this riff. For that one, we'll go to fret 5 on the G string, fret 7, we'll go to the B string fret 5, 6, 8, the high E string fret 5, fret 6, and end on fret 5. Again. So here's the entire thing. For our next riff, we'll play this. For this riff, we're going to start at fret 5 on the A string, go to 5, fret 8 on the low E string, back to 5 on the A string. So that's... We'll go to fret 7 on the A string, fret 8, back to 7, 8. So that's... We'll go to fret 5 on the D string. Then we'll go to 7 on the D string. So we've got... Then we'll go to the G string and bounce back and forth. And that's fret 7 on the G string, so it's... And then we'll go to the D string, fret 7, and hammer on to fret 8, like that, so it's... Then we'll go to the D string, fret 5, to fret 8 on the A string, so that's... So we bounce from fret 5 to 8, back to 5. So it's... Then we'll go to fret 7 on the D string, to fret 8 on the A string, to fret 5, and we play that twice. Then we wind up at fret 8 on the A string. So the entire thing is... Let's play like this. After that, we'll climb the neck of the guitar like this. So for that, we're going to go down here to fret 2 on the D string, sliding in to fret 3, and then we'll land on the G string, fret 2. So that's... And we'll keep doing this sort of thing all the way up to neck. We'll go to fret 3 and slide to fret 5. on the D string and land on the G string fret 3. So that's. Then we'll move up to fret 5, sliding up to fret 7, and landing on the G string fret 5. So that's. And the next time, we'll move up by one fret from 7-8. And that's on the D string, going to the G string at fret 7. And we'll do the same thing, sliding up to fret 10 and landing on fret 9 of the G string. We'll do it one more time between fret 12 and 10. We'll go up to 12 on the D string, land on 10 on the G string. Then we'll move up to fret 15 on the D string and play this riff. So we're at fret 15 on the D string, fret 17, fret 14 on the G string, 15, 17, and then we'll go to 16 on the B string and bend it up and hold it. So here's what we've got. And then we'll slide that down. Like that. Once again, here's the entire thing. Now we're at my favorite riff of the entire song. It goes like this. For that one, we're going to start at fret 1 on the low E string, and then go to fret 3 and strike it 3 times. Back to fret 1, fret 3, fret 1 on the A string, fret 3 again on the low E string. Fret 3 on the A string, back to 1. So that's. Then we'll slide from fret 3 to 5 and do this. So we slid from fret 3 to 5, back to 3, 3 on the D string, and then back to the A string. Then we'll go to fret 5 on the D string and play this. That's fret 5, fret 3, fret 3 on the G string, and then back to fret 5. So that's. Then we'll go to the G string, sliding from fret 5 to 7. And then we'll go back to 5, and then go to the B string, fret 6, and then to fret 8. So the entire thing is. And that riff is played twice. Next, we'll play this. So for that, we simply went to the D string, fret 5, fret 3, back to 5, and the low E string, fret 3. And then we went back and did the same thing. And then we went to the G string, fret 3. Like that, so it's... After that, we're going to turn on our wah pedal and do a riff that's really cool. For this part of the song, we'll be doing double stops like this. We'll place the index finger on fret 8 of the B string and go up to the 11th fret on the G string with the ring finger. And we're going to bend the ring finger note up while we hold the index finger note down in place, like that. Now we'll use the wah in just a moment to make this sound more dramatic, but we're going to start at fret 8 to 11, then we'll go to fret 10 and 13, and that's on the B string and G string. Then we'll go to 11, 14, 13, 16, 15, 18, 17, and 20. Then we'll go to the high E string and the B string and go to fret 13 and 17. So that's quite a stretch. Then we'll go to 15 and 19, 18 and 22. So once again, that's starting at fret 8, fret 10, fret 11, 13, 15, 17, moving to the high E and B string, fret 13, 15, and 18. Let's do it with the wah. So now, every time we do one of these, we'll engage the wah pedal like this. Take it all the way up and then bring it all the way back. Now after the drum solo, we're going to go to a little part that goes something like this. We're simply banging on the third fret of the low E string starting out, and we'll play this. After doing that four times, we'll do this. And we'll do that four times. That's fret 3 on the low E string, fret 1 or B flat on the A string, and then back to fret 3, and then fret 1 on the low E string. So it's... We'll get out of that by playing this. And that was 3 on the low E string, fret 1 on the A string and end on fret 3 of the low E string. Next, we'll go back to the main riff and we'll play what we played in the beginning. We'll repeat this. In order to play that, we simply went up to the 5th fret on the A string, the 4th fret sliding down to fret 3, fret 1, and then the low E string fret 3. And that's... We did that 3 times, and then we'll go to a power chord at fret 1, a B flat 5 power chord. That's fret 1 and fret 3. Fret 1 on the A string, fret 3 on the D string. And then we'll raise that by 2 frets. Now we'll finish by going to fret 3 for G minor right here, fret 3. Right? And we'll start here and we'll do this, playing double stops. Okay, so we're going to go to the B string and the high E string, go to fret 3, drag it down to fret 1, back to fret 3, so that's... Then we'll go to fret 6, drag it down to fret 3. Then we'll go to fret 8, drag it down to fret 6 and back. Then we'll go to fret 10. That was 10 to 8. Then we'll go to 13 to 10. Then we'll go to 15, 13 and back. Then 18 to 15 and back. 20, 18 to 20. And then we'll end on 18 and slide it down. So here it is. Well, all right, my friends, you got your work cut out for you. That's how I play Frankenstein by the Edgar Winter Group on electric guitar. Thanks for stopping by, and have a great day.